Today, I will push my project to GitLab and create a dedicated pipeline to package my project and deploy it somewhere. I want my pipeline to be different depending on the branch and on the stability. And I will do all of this in less than 10 minutes. GitLab is known to be a remote server, where everyone can store its project. It's like GitHub. And as with the GitHub Actions, I have the CICD section, a continuous integration and continuous deployment section in GitLab, called GitlabCI. The CICD pipelines in GitLab are first composed by jobs. A job is the action I want to execute in my project. Compile, run the unit test, run the integration test, deploy somewhere, and more. The jobs can have a single comment or multiples. If a single comment fails, the job will stop and return an error to the pipeline. Then comes the stages. A stage is a group of jobs. I may have a stage to test, and independent jobs to run the unit test, the integration test, and the load test. All the jobs in a stage can run in parallel. When all the jobs finishes successfully, the next stage is started. For example, the packaging stage or the deploy stage that can be executed only if the tests are successfully. And finally comes the conditions. I can apply some conditions to the jobs as dependency between them. This makes my jobs to run sequentially. Or I can execute some jobs only in a specific branch or tag. This way I can have the master branch which only runs the unit test and the deploy, and the other branches which run the integration test but not the deploy. Okay, but where are executed those jobs? In runners. With GitLabCI, I can configure multiple runners to accept jobs. I can have shared runners or specific runners. The shared runners will be used for all the projects in my GitLabCI instance. The specific runners will be dedicated to a single project. Today, I will use a specific runner from my machine. When a new commit arrives to GitLab, GitLabCI will check the conditions to run the job. And if some runner is available, it will assign the job. Okay, the configuration of my pipeline will be done in a YAML file. This YAML file will be located inside the project. This way, the project contains the way it must be built and deployed all together. Let's start by creating this file. I first define the two stages I want, the test stage and the deploy stage. The test stage will contain the unit test for the master branch and the integration test for the other branches. And the deploy stage will only be available for the master branch. As I have nowhere to deploy my application yet, this will be a fake deploy. Let's start by integration test for all the branches but master. This is the name of my job. I can name it as I want. Here is the stage where my job is located. Now I indicate that I don't want to execute this job on master. And finally, the commands to be run by this job. Let's go now with the job of the master branch. As before, the name of the job, then the associated stage. This time I indicate that this job will only be executed in the master branch. Finally, the scripts to run the unit tests. I've added another command, which copied the jar file and rename it with the hash of the commit. As this job will be executed only in master, I want to keep a trace of all that will be built and deployed. The hash of the commit is a GitLab environment variable. I have hundreds more, as the local branch, the project name, the pipeline ID, and more. I can also set my own environment variables per job or per pipeline. Now, save back the jar file as an artifact. This artifact will be available in the GitLabCI interface. We will see it later. Let's go now to the latest job, the deploy. Here I've introduced a new concept, the needs, the dependency with the unit test job. This means that the deploy job will only be executed if the unit test job is successful. That's all for the pipeline. Nevertheless, I have no runner configured in my GitlabCI account. I will create one on my local machine, attach it to my GitHub account, and use it to execute the pipelines. In the settings section of my project at GitLab, I have the CICD tab. In the runners section, I can see the shared runners and the specific runners. To use the specific runners, I must ensure that the shared runners are disabled. Then here I have the instructions to create my own runner. I will create my runner, not in my machine, but in a Docker image. I will start a Java image and run all of those commands inside. Let's check now the status of my runners. And if I go to GitLab again, I will see it. But my runner isn't ready yet. As it's a Java image, I need some dependencies, mainly Maven. I will install it in my runner first. Okay, my runner contains Java and Maven. Let's go back now to GitLab and add some tags to my runner. The tags will define on which runner my job can be run, so I will add some to my pipeline configuration. Those jobs need Maven. The deploy job doesn't need anything, so I add no tag. As I have only one runner, this seems to be useless. But if I have several runners with different configurations, this becomes useful. I can have three runners, a plain Linux one, a Java one, and a Node.js one. Then in my pipeline configuration, I indicate which runner I want for each job. I've made several tests, and I need to add those lines as a before script if I want my runner to recognize both Java and Maven. I don't know why. If somebody knows the reason, please leave a comment with the solution. The before script section is a section that will be run before each job. Let's now push my pipeline and see the results. Here is the result of my pipeline. In the master branch, I have the test unit and deploy job, which were executed. If I enter in a single job, I can see the logs generated by the job. And going to the pipeline list page, I can download the artifact generated by the test unit job. I've used a single runner on my machine. Nevertheless, in companies, it used to be shared runners and auto-scaled runners. The runners will be available in some Kubernetes-like architecture. Having the runners in a Docker environment, I can't install the dependencies as I did with Maven. Instead, I have the image keyword. The image keyword allows me to indicate at the job level or at the pipeline level which Docker image to use. Then I can make some specific installations in the before script section if needed. I also have the service keyword, which works similarly to the image keyword. With the service keyword, I can create a Docker image which will be available to a specific job. I can have my unit tests running in Java and have a Postgres service next to it to run the integration tests. Okay, let's make a quick recap. I've created a GitlabCI YAML file in the project which will contain the pipeline configuration. I've added a job to run all the tests, excluding the master branch. I've added another job to only run the unit tests, but only for the master branch. I've added one last job to fake deploy my application. This last job has a dependency with the unit test job. I've saved the jar file as an artifact to have it available from the GitLab interface. I've added the tags to select the runner I want, and I've created my specific runner on my machine. That's all for today, and in less than 10 minutes. So please, click on the thumbs up, leave a comment, and see you soon. Bye!